Hi, I'm Kate. This is our threading video for threading 70mm on the DP70. It's got many things in common with the 35mm projector, except twice as wide. Before you get started, you want to make sure that you have your projector set ready to go threading in 70, which we cover how to transition to another video. And you're also going to want to make sure that you have the lens focus before you start trying to run film, which we also cover in another video. The biggest difference between R70 and R35 is that R35 sound reader is optical, which involves putting the film down over here, whereas with 70 it's magnetic, which we have in a different part of the projector over here. So because of that, our threading diagram is different. We have both the 35mm optical and the 70mm magnetic threading diagrams taped to the projector here, so we can easily refer back to them. One important thing to note with 70mm film is that it is very easy to destroy, so you have to make sure that you're paying close attention to it while it's running, and because it's very easy for the film to get cut down the middle. Another thing is that our shoes also don't snap into place, they will just drop right down, which you want to keep in mind while you're threading so you don't destroy any of the sprocket holes, which will help ensure that the film stays in good quality and also doesn't get shredded or tear apart the entire film. Another thing is we also have different lenses and different dowser plates for the 70mm projector. Ours has a lovely guide telling you that you turn up with the 35mm lens and you turn down with the 70. Other than that, and the fact that it is twice as wide, it's very similar to the 35. I'll get showing you how to thread it. First thing we want to keep in mind when we're threading the 70 is that we need a lot more film out in order for it to make its way all the way down to the take-up reel than we do with 35. I already got my reel of film previews and I take-up reel already here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take out a fair amount of film. Usually with threading our 35 or our 60mm projectors, we want roughly the amount that takes to go to the floor. We want more than that for 70 in order for it to reach. We also want to make sure that the film doesn't drag on the floor in the process, because that can make it dirty and damaged, and nobody wants that. All right, that looks like about enough. It's the sort of thing that there isn't really an exact science to it. You just kind of have to keep practicing getting the right amount, and if it's too short, then you start over and try again until you figure out what the right length is. So I'll be following our threading diagram right here, which is super handy in order to make sure that we follow it correctly. First thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to take the film under this first area and put it around this constant motion sprocket. Another thing with 70 is that we have an extra constant motion sprocket compared to with 35. This is the only one where the shoe does stay out of the way on its own without like any tension, so that's very nice. We want to make sure we close it just to keep it nice and secure in place for the rest of the threading. Next, we follow our threading diagram down around the first roller and then up around the second. So this right here, this moves and we'll press up against the film. So we want to make sure that it's securely around without being pinched by the edges before we pull it up. You also want to make sure you don't pull it down too wide, because bits of the projector will get in the way if you do, in order to make sure you don't pinch any film. Then, once you got that around, you pull it up over this metallic guy right here and through the magnetic sound reader, and then around to the other side. And this is somewhat of a mirror image, so you keep following the threading diagram around. Once you've got it around the sound reader area, you want to bring it over to this constant motion sprocket, just like you would with 35. Following the threading diagram. Now, before you close this shoe, which this one also doesn't have the same tension as the other 70, so it will stay open, you want to make sure that you have the tension right going through the mag reader. So luckily our 70 projector has this nice little diagram with red arrows that we can use in order to determine where the tension is right. So we want to pull the film to the point that those arrows line up. To make sure we have the tension right, And we also want to make sure that we have the sprocket holes nice and straight with the sprockets, so that way we don't damage the film. From there, thing is that because these move, the tension isn't actually exact. So we want to push back up against this one right here in order to make the film actually show where the true spot of the arrows are. So we pull up on the tension a little bit more until we get to the point where when we push back, the arrows line up. It takes a few tries in order to make sure that you've got the film lined up with the right tension, but when you can push on this roller right here, you can see that the arrows are lined up, which means that the tension is right. When you release it, the arrows do change, but you want to check when you are applying pressure to it. That will ensure that it's in the right spot when the projector is running, as it will move back and forth depending on like it's the time going through the frame. Once you're confident that you've got the tension in the sound reader right, you can pull up the film and close this shoe just like you would with 35 and pull it down under. Next step is bringing it through around where the light will be coming out, just like with 35, except it's wider. So that is going to make a significant difference when we get to making sure the loop size is right. But for now, we're gonna make sure we just have the film accurately on the sprocket holes, and then we'll adjust from there. We wanna make sure, because this shoe doesn't stay open, we wanna make sure we are holding it down so that way it doesn't pinch the film in a potentially damaging way. Once we've got the film securely on the intermittent motion sprocket, we can pull it up and close the gate. Now right here, we can see that our loop is far too small. That's gonna put too much tension on the film, which could potentially damage it. Normally with 35, what we wanna do is make the film go through this circle right here, but because of how 70 is wider, if we actually try to do that, it would be rubbing where the pressure bands live. So we want to make it just under, and so that's going to take a little bit of practicing. 35, we would usually adjust it from this constant motion sprocket end, but because we already got our magnetic all nice and perfectly set, we're going to actually do it down here on the intermittent sprocket side. So what we want to do is loosen our film quite a bit. Make sure we have it, the holes all nice and lined up, stabbing through before we close the shoe. And then we're gonna wanna make sure the film is nice and straight. We'll close the gate and we'll check the loop. Once we've fiddled around with where we want the film up against the sprockets, we can close the gate to check the loop size again. If the gate's fully closed, we have our film is just about under where it would be going through. So that's roughly where we want it, because of the way that the 70 works, if the loop was any bigger, it would be rubbing up here. But it won't be, so that's nice. And we can continue following the diagram down. So the next thing that we want to keep in mind is, because we don't follow the optical sound reader like we do with 35, we're going to need to have some more places that have less tension before bringing it down to this constant motion sprocket. So when we're following our diagram, we do see a loop right after going through here, and we want to make sure we follow that so that way we have some looseness to the film. If anything bad happens, the film doesn't get shredded. So we want to bring film down, following our threading diagram, down to this constant motion sprocket. Now, making sure we have the right size loop, we can just put this in its place and close it. This shoe also will automatically close. So you want to make sure that you have it in the right spot before you let it close, so that way the sprocket holes aren't being squished. Now right here, we can see that we don't have much of a loop right outside of the intermittent sprocket, so we need to loosen that. So we're going to take our film, scooch it up few sprocket holes, and then check that loop size. You want a loop big enough that there's plenty of wiggle room just in case anything goes bad, but you don't want it so big that it's going to be rubbing up against any other parts of the projector, because that will damage the film. When we've got our loop a sufficient size, that looks about right. We've got plenty of looseness for the in between the sprockets, but it's also not going to be rubbing against any parts of the projector. We now want to come down, make sure we have our film going through nice and straight. It helps if you already have the film starting to go down towards the take-up reel while you do that, because it'll help keep the film nice and straight, which means that it won't be rubbing against the shoe in a weird way that causes it to get pinched. Once we're confident that we have the right size loop here, right size loop here, and the right amount of tension here, we can bring it all the way down in order to make sure that it doesn't get pinched on this last shoe. And so we're confident that that is all straight and that our loops are the right sizes everywhere, that we've got the right amount of tension on our magnetic reader. We can bring the film down following our threading diagram, just like we do for 35, down here, around, and then we tape it securely to our take-up reel. Looking at our threading diagram, we can see that we want the film going towards the right, just like we do for 35. We want to make sure we have it nice and secured on the take-up reel, that the tape is holding the film in place. Once we've got that all set, next thing we want to do is go back and check over our threading to make sure we didn't make any mistakes. We like to start at the bottom, so following along with our threading diagram, it feels like the film is not sliding when we try to turn the wheel, which means the tape is keeping it nice and secured, which is what we want, so we don't have a bunch of projector spaghetti on the ground. Following that, we're going in the right direction, matching the threading diagram up, around, and back up, just like on the diagram. Up here with the constant motion sprocket, we want to feel to make sure that we can feel the pointy bits, that the film is going through nice and straight, which it is, making sure our gate is closed, which it is. Going up, we're following the threading diagram, and we can see that we have about a good sized loop. It matches the one in the threading diagram pretty well, and it doesn't look like it should be rubbing on any parts of the projector that would be bad for it. Next, so we're confident in that loop size, we want to check to make sure that it is going through the intermittent sprocket nice and smoothly, which we do by feeling for the pointy bits with our finger, because it would be a little bit hard to see. And we know that the shoe right there is closed, which is what we want. On the other side of it, we can feel with our finger that there are the pointy bits. Going up around, we can see right here that it is going through straight, which is what we want. Looking up at the top loop, it goes a little bit under the circle, which is what we want for 70, so that way it's not dragging. And around to this constant motion sprocket. We can feel here at this constant motion sprocket that we can feel our spiky bits on both sides of the shoe. So we know that this is on here straight, and we've got our shoe closed, which is what we want. If any of the shoes end up being open, it could severely damage the film. Then going from there, keeping following the diagram, we go around and up and through the magnetic reader, and back down and around, so we're making sure we're following everything on the diagram. And we can see right here, when we push here, our arrows line up. I'm pushing it and it won't go any further, so that's what we want. So we know that that amount of tension is right. Then we're going up to this very first constant motion sprocket. We can feel both sides, can feel the spikes. It looks like it's straight, it's going through straight, and this shoe is closed. Up here to right at the beginning, we're still following the diagram, up, around, and up to the reel, and the film is going towards the left, which is what we have on the diagram, so we know it's going right. Last few things before we check. We've got that closed, we've got that closed, so our reels won't come off while the projector is running. We've got this bad boy where it needs to be. We've got our gate closed. The projector was in threading position in order for us to thread it. And that's everything that we need to check for threading. Once we're confident in what we've done for threading, we can essentially do a trial advance. So what we want to do is we want to grab what basically spins when the projector is running and spin it ourselves to make sure that the film moves through smoothly. So we keep spinning it. This is basically what will happen when the projector is running. We want to look everywhere that the film goes through, making sure that it's going through smoothly, that we aren't damaging any sprocket holes, no scary sounds that aren't supposed to be there. And it looks like everything's all set. Our loops are staying good sizes where they shouldn't be rubbing against anything, which means we got our tension nice and right. If we're looking up here, we can see the red arrows.
We're not actually here. And we don't really run 400 flights a day out of here. Or 500 tons of